So thank you for getting back to the channel. This is part two. Last week was part one of this the video I made today, and I'm just having an amazing day. So yeah, if you haven't seen part one yet, there's a link up here somewhere. I'm sure it will be worth it. I haven't seen the images yet, but yeah, I'm just having one of these mornings where everything seems to go come together. I've shot landscapes, I've shot sunrise, I shot deers, I shot macro images. I just got a couple of stunning woodland pictures here that I'm really excited about. So everything seems to come together. So yeah, join me on part two of this video. So let me know in the comments down here what you think of it. And if you didn't subscribe yet, then please push the subscribe button. And yeah, I hope to see you on the next video too. So let's get into it. I think this is turning out to be one of these days where I shoot the whole package. So I've got beautiful landscape, beautiful sunrise, I shot a deer, I shoot a caterpillar, and now I just found a reason to put on the 300mm f4 with teleconverter, and I just shot a beautiful bird sitting in this tree here, and it was making his call. So it's a little bit of an action shot also, I think, but yeah, I don't know what it is this morning, but it's just amazing. So I was just thinking that I just felt really lucky to be out here today, but I'm actually having a lot of luck lately. I don't know what it is and what I deserve this for, but since I'm making these YouTube videos, I'm experiencing so many beautiful mornings. And maybe it's because I have a reason to go out that I'm getting into these mornings, because maybe I wouldn't have gone out today or the other mornings that I had some great photos, but yeah, I just don't know what it is, but yeah, I'm taking it. So I'm on my way back to the car to drive to the forest, hopefully do some woodland photography there with some fork in it, when I came across this beautiful scene here. And I'll try to show you what I'm looking at. I think I already shot it this morning also, but there's a bit of an S-curve here, and there's some beautiful trees and just some diagonal lines. So that's I think this might be a really nice shot. And yeah, the light is a bit harsh, but yeah, I just love the fog at the moment. So I think this morning I got quite a similar one with the sunrise above it. But now I'm just only concentrating in this part in the valley. So yeah, hopefully this will turn out to be a nice shot. I'm always taking about f8 shots right now to get everything as sharp as possible. So yeah, I'm gonna take it right now because the fog is a little bit clearing, and you can see this white one triangle shape extra that I didn't see earlier. So I'm gonna take it now, and if it's something good, this is the shot. The light just got a little bit harsh, so what I decided to do, if you look behind me in this direction, It looks like there's a lot of fog concentrating on that side of this this nature reserve, and yeah, there's a beautiful forest there where I've shot before, and yeah, hopefully this fog will be in that forest, and yeah, I can continue shooting on for a little while. So yeah, absolutely amazed by the images I already got today, but let's see if we can put some nice forest. Forest photos with it also, and yeah, that would wrap up the day as maybe the ultimate day of nature photography. It just has it all. So I had to walk back quite a bit because I lost my microphone. Luckily I found it. But I lost one in an earlier video, one of my first videos, and it cost me 100 euros to buy a new one. So if there's anybody watching using this DJI Osmo Pocket 2 with this wireless microphone, and you have a tip for me how to prevent me from losing this, to how do you attach it, or I'm just thinking about drilling a hole into it and attaching it with some kind of wire so it can't fall off. But if you have any tips for me, then please leave them in a comment. I'll be very interested in finding out your solution. So I think by now it would be appropriate to thank the people at the OM System in the Netherlands for lending me this OM1. So Mark and Ingrid, thank you for giving me this on loan. I think if you wouldn't have done that, I wouldn't have been out today, and I would have missed these epic conditions. So this is the only day in the week that I found some space to test this out. And yeah, I think if I wouldn't have had this, I would be sitting at home processing all my Scotland photos and videos. You've already seen them by now, but yeah, I've got tons of material to go through, so there's even more coming today. So I've got enough to do for a couple of days. So yeah, but what I said, thanks for giving me this opportunity, and yeah, I'm really enthusiastic about this. So hopefully the people watching this will be too. So I found a nice piece of woodland here. Yeah, where there's still some fog in it. And yeah, the woodland I actually wanted to go to, yeah, that was clear of fog. So I drove back and found this area where there's still a little bit of fog, especially when you shoot straight into the sun. So yeah, I'm gonna scout around here a bit. Hopefully I can find a nice composition here. And yeah, then I've got something to show you. Look at this, people. This is the kind of shot that gets me really excited. So look behind me here. There's just this little curved little tree, and The rest are all big trees with straight trunks going up. There's light coming through beautifully, some fog in the background. What more do you want? So I'm actually using the long lens here, the 40-150. And when you use a zoom lens in a woodland, you can compress the scene a little bit. So those trees appear much closer than they are in real life. So that creates so much mystery in woodland shots. So really happy with this. So I've got the scene here. I'm at F11, a 50th of a second, ISO 200, and I actually put it on the tripod. I think this camera could perfectly manage to take the shot handheld with the image stabilization that's in it. It's brilliant. But with a shot like this, I'm not taking any risks. I'm gonna take it on the tripod, just like this. So 5 second timer, here we go. Amazing. What more do you want? If I'm really criticizing here, a little bit of light on the leaves of that little tree, that would be brilliant. So I walked down this path a couple of times and took a couple of shots here and there, but I just keep coming back to this little tree that I started out with. It's just such an amazing scene, and the only thing is that I'm waiting for the light, and it just looks like the sun is going to come through a gap in the forest, the treetops, and hopefully. Yeah, there it comes. Yeah, this is perfect. Absolutely amazing. I don't know what to say. This might be the best shot of the day. I don't know, but I took a lot of good shots today. So, but we will see. Hopefully this camera won't disappoint me. I'm actually counting on the dynamic range of this camera to be, hopefully to be quite good, because I made it a quite dark image. It's f16 and 1/25th of a second and ISO 200. So yeah, it would be interesting to see what I can pull out of this image, but hopefully it will turn out to be really good. I might actually, just to make this image a little bit snappier, try to put on a polarizer. I have a polarizer for this lens, so. Let's try that. So I got the polarizer on right now, but it's not having too much effect, unfortunately, because that's mainly because I'm shooting straight into the sun. Usually those polarizers work best when you're facing with side light, but it did give a little bit more touch to this green grasses in the foreground. So amazing scene. I think I got the best possible image here, so I'm heading out for the next image. Just taking one more to be sure. So I think this is the end of today's video. I think you're watching part two now when I'm talking to you now. And yeah, it was an amazing day. I've had so many great shots here that, yeah, I haven't seen them yet, but it's one of those days where everything seems to fall together. Landscape, sunrises, I saw a deer, took some macro images, shot some birds, got some beautiful woodland images right here. So yeah, really happy with today. And I think I especially have to thank the people at OM Systems in the Netherlands for giving me this camera on loan, because yeah, if they wouldn't have given this to me, then I wouldn't be out here today, because I just got back from Scotland. I've got tons of images and video material to process, and I think I would be behind my laptop doing that right now. But they give me a reason to get out here, and that's the reason I'm here. So Mark and Ingrid, thank you. I think you made this possible, this video possible. So yeah, I hope you are watching, and I hope I can give a nice review on this camera. My first thoughts are really positive. Haven't seen the images yet, but I think I will make a video of that. So thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and last week's video, and hopefully all my videos. So if you did, then please push that subscribe button if you didn't already do. It's right beneath this video. If you push it, there's also a little notification bell. If you push that and select all, then you will get a notification when I release my next video. It's totally free. You don't have to pay anything for it, but it will massively help me to grow this channel. So if you like the video, then of course push the thumbs up button, and I hope to see you on the next one. Bye for now.